So first off, oh, like for a sec. Okay, hi everyone. My name is Thomas, Tom Front. First time again, second time showing my face. I was planning on making this as a live stream for the 4.1 special program, but I was dead. I didn't even have the strength to go live in the middle of the night. It will be like at 4:30 a.m. by the time they start the program. So I'm gonna be watching on YouTube. It's gonna be my first time. I am not aware of what happened. I just only redeemed the codes, and that's that. So let's look. I really wonder what we have here. So let's go over here. So it's gonna be like an hour. Jesus Christ. Yep, it looks like we're gonna have a new map expansion, right? Wow,
我是你们的老朋友大伟哥。
That's so good.
呈现给每一位旅行者，希望旅行者们无论是在游戏内还是游戏外，都能够感受到三周年的节日氛围。All right，那么，这一次，先让我们一起来观赏版本PV，看看新版本啊，
the third anniversary
会给我们带来哪些精彩的内容吧。Okay,
let's look at the trailer. Dude, I'm very curious. Piebald Yeah. What the fuck?
The fortress of Meripede may seem like a prison, but it should in fact be regarded as a gathering place for exiles. I will arrange false charges against you so that you may secretly investigate inside the fortress.
The truth is, this place has a lot of hidden rules.
Who's
all of our informants, including the ones that had infiltrated the guards,
Lenny?
Suddenly vanished.
Something bad will happen during lunch on the third day.
A mysterious box? A bottle of crimson liquid?
So, you know those pipes that make strange sounds? Don't ever,
oh boy, baby,
ever go near them at night.
Sooner or later, all will pay the price for their arrogance.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Yeah! He's a brawler, okay.
Could get a little chilly.
Yeah, no shit. Oh shit.
Time's up. Negotiations have broken down. Please leave, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow, he's dope.
If Risley does have a plan, what could it be?
Risley,
after being away from the sunlight for so long, even the terrifying depths of the sea start to feel like
home.
I have to.
Come in, eh? Oh,
have
shit.
We entered into the next stage of the prophecy?
And now, another catastrophe will soon be upon us. I mourn this turn of events.
Nebulet. Wow, what a such a book!
I find it difficult to express my emotions because I cannot fully understand myself.
I'm confident that we'll find the meaning of our existence one day.
Rumors saying that you were born from calamity. You inherently bring danger to those around you.
Why should we trust this species from who knows where anyway?
Melazines can't be trusted! That goes for Nervalette too!
There's only one thought on my mind. Only
innocent.
Through bloodshed can their debt be repaid.
Risley!
Where did you take my siblings?
Even if the truth may not be pleasant, since they have no way to dispose of the leftover remains,
is that an actual icon?
They have ways to transform them into other forms and keep them in the fortress forever.
It beggars belief just how carefree you have been. From the very beginning, you, the god Fossilor, have failed to take action.
Who are you? What are you trying to do? Please, don't kill me! I'm begging you!
Is this what justice means to you? Answer me, Nubilat!
Oh my god.
You will see much in the human world, from the delightful to the depressing. And one day, when you have dwelt among humanity long enough, you will be placed to bring judgment over all as a spokesperson for Fontaine's past.
It is unnecessary to hold me in such high regard.
Wow, old Fontaine. Dude! To the star shining in the depth. Wow, that was a sick traitor. Oh wow, I have too many questions. Are we gonna learn about Nubilat's past and everything?
What the fuck?Dude,
that's unbelievable. 4.1 already. It doesn't feel like the Fontaine has been out for like too long.
旅行者们，大家好，这次会由我来向各位旅行者介绍剧情和角色的相关内容。
哎，欢迎欢迎！哎，自从做完这个4.0的模式任务以后啊，我一直想知道之后的发展。趁着这次机会啊，叶黑啊，先和我们聊聊4.1版本的模式任务好了。
好，先问一下大伟哥，还记得4.0相关的版本剧情吗？
有印象。
啊，被读到太远了哈。简
单回顾一下吧。
没问题，我们初到枫丹时就协助林尼、纳维亚他们解决了几宗案件。但其实最后都汇聚到了一个案件上，也就是
少女连环失踪案。
而且在此期间，愚人众的执行官公子还有于不明的原因被审判送进了梅洛彼得堡。
Yeah?
看到这里的时候我就在想啊，被审判的可是愚人众的执行官啊，怎么看也不是一件小事，愚人众应该不会坐视不管吧，是不是会有新的执行官因此登场呢？
大伟哥很敏锐啊。没错，在 4.1 版本中，故乡为枫丹的执行官仆人，为了处理这起外交事件，也前来与水神弗林达以及最高审判官纳维莱特会面。
First appearance of Arcadina，
这场面想想就很精彩。
那是必然的，而且仆人提出的几个方案其实都被婉拒了。
这么一听啊，感觉火药味很浓啊。
是有那么一点，不过最终纳维莱特还是答应派人前去梅洛彼得堡确认公子的情况，这才暂且压下了这股火药味。
我猜猜。所以这个任务就落到了我们旅行者的肩上。
This is so good. I can't wait already, man.
为了让我们顺利融入梅洛彼得堡，贴心的纳维莱特先生给我们安排了一个小小的罪名。哦，对，这里就得简单提一下梅洛彼得堡的设定，因为梅洛彼得堡并不是简单枫丹监狱这一个概念，它本身并不隶属于枫丹的司法体系，一直都是以自治的形式而存在，所以纳维莱特才需要让我们伪装成囚犯下去调查。
Oh, I thought that was real. Oh my fucking god, dude. I thought we got caught by injustice.
魔神任务第三幕向深水中的晨星和第四
幕
御史胎动的中烟之客也将会开启。
Two archons again. Awesome.
一系列的事件以及追寻公子的行踪。值得一提的是，这个过程中旅行者会得到一些老朋友的帮助，也会遇到一些新的面孔。
That's so good.
比如梅洛彼得堡的公爵莱欧斯利以及护士长西格文。展开一系列的冒险故事。
I might have to skip at some point because there were too many things that were discussed, and I think I'm getting the grasp of it. Like just now, yeah. Let's see the character details.
作为梅洛彼得堡的管理人，莱欧斯利确实。
What, Joe? The voice actor, I know him. Oh my god! You can see on my face cam, but Joe's Zaija, I think.I know this guy because I keep seeing his ad on Instagram. Oh my god. It's this guy. I'll show you one sec. That's him. Wait, maybe I can do that. That's this dude. He's voicing this guy, dude. Oh my god. I know him. I'm so surprised it's him voicing.
也能镇得住强势的恶棍。 在他上位后实施了一系列的改革，让梅洛彼得
堡焕然一新。I'm surprised
about this. 也正是因为如此，梅洛彼得堡并不是像大家所想的那样如监狱一般，甚至有一些刑满释放的罪人都不愿意离开了。
听你这么一说啊，这位公爵可真是不得了啊。不过啊，梅洛彼得堡作为全丰南罪人的流放地啊，
wow,
只有高超的管理手腕。
This changes everything right now.
想必他也拥有令人信服的实力吧。
It's insane.
作为犯人的流放聚集地，梅罗彼得堡多多少少总会有一些不服从管理的犯人，这时候道理讲不通，就只能通过其他方法以理服人了。而莱欧斯利自然也不缺乏这方面的实力，由于莱欧斯利之前当过地下拳手，因此拥有高超的战斗技巧。
So first Cryo Cat is then, right? Because he's a brawler?
形势复杂的地方，拳头有时候才是硬道理嘛。
搏击意味着力量的碰撞，但也常有故意卖弄破绽给对方。
Man, I thought it was gonna be like a four-star character or something, but no.
作为一个冰元素的法器使用者，莱欧斯利的普通攻击和重击。
Yep, guys, what the fuck?
元素战技。
Wait, let me read this. Hang on. When Yoshi's HP fall below a certain amount, his next charge attack will be enhanced to become Rebuke, Bunting Fist that deals more damage. It will not consume stamina, and after hitting, will restore HP for Yoshi. By combining his normal attacks that has been enhanced by his elemental skill, Yoshi can control his HP fluctuation and buff his normal attacks and charge attacks. Oh shit, dude! Oh my god. Wait, so he can. He plays with his HP fluctuation. By doing so, he can enhance his normal attack by using his elemental skill and I think charge attack as well. What the hell?
这会强化他的普通攻击，同时损失生命值。不过不用担心，这些损失的生命值正是他用来引诱对手进攻和抓住观众的。
Shit!
在莱欧斯利的生命值较低时。他的重击则会被大幅的强化，并在命中敌人后大量恢复自身的生命值。
看完他的技能
，What's his weapon? I wanna know.
战斗方式了，占据优势时对敌人穷追猛打。
He looks like he can use like the Scaramouche's bell.
让敌人有机可乘，之后在危机时一发逆转玩弄敌人。
大卫哥的描述可真是生动形象。
I wanna know his weapon.
他的战斗方式与他的处事风格可谓十分的相似。此外，莱欧斯利也非常擅长调度资源。在合成武器突破数材时，莱欧斯利
double products
获得双倍的产
出。Okay, that's interesting.
这位公爵大人可真是多才多艺啊！管理、战斗。
It really doesn't happen with me so often with the characters, but still, man, come on.
不过虽然莱欧斯利做事
用了
一套手段，但梅洛彼得堡毕竟是建立在枫丹的水下，常年见不到阳光，在监狱的阴暗角落里，依然会有邪恶在滋生。在 4.1 版本中。莱欧斯利的传说
任务。Ooh, okay, story quest. Okay, so I don't know what are the orders of the banners. Is he gonna rerun first?
Don't break them off. Is there anything else? Yeah, seriously, don't break the law.
Okay, dude. I think he's nuts to crack. I think I'm needing him.
A moment, please.
A moment, please. Oh my fucking god. I want him,
perhaps,
dude.
We could take a walk by a riverbank or somewhere similarly fluvial.
And him too. I want both of them. I want both of them, actually. I don't care. I want both of them. He has a sick ass book.
Be sanctified.
Wow. Oh my god, he has the power of like the water droplet that shows you water at your face.
4.1 版本上线的另一位角色，
这
是枫丹的最高审判官纳维莱特。在 4.0 版本中，我们就已经和他打过交道。
Oh my god!
相信大伟哥一定不会陌生吧？
嗯，我在纳维莱特印象非常深刻。他的审判时啊，公正无私，而且实力非常强大，给人一种深不可测的感觉。
其实枫丹的很多人对于拉维莱特的形象认知都是这样的。
Rage Chase, hang on a second.
拉维莱特身为枫丹的最高审判官，主持着枫丹关于正义的审判体系，需要维持公正的原则，不仅是在法庭之上。
Oh my god, I know him. Okay, got him.
他也会时刻注意公众的影响，比如他会尽量避免与他人有私交，以及有流程外的协作，防止被人怀疑司法体系的不公。
他对自己的要求啊可真严格啊，不愧是最高审判官，严于律己啊。
没错，不过这位最高审判官也没大家想象的那么严肃罢了。
Okay, I want to see his gameplay.
可以这么拼啊，想不到只是
纳维莱特既有对公的一面，其实也有对私的一面。
Yeah, he's private.
喜爱美露心，认为他们是一个善良美丽的。
They're so cute.
纳维莱特甚至在枫丹法规中加入了一条巧妙的法律，对美露心的称呼必须使用人格意味的他。而不能用他。
Oh my god！
作为最高审判官，还有这样的一面。不过美露心确实十分可爱。
Dog,
我十分理解她的行为。
其实还有一支直接隶属于最高审判官的特别刑侦机构——烛影亭，绝大多数雇员都是由美露心组成的。
That's interesting to know。
纳维莱特偏心，因为美露心们纳维莱特收集。
Okay, let me see. What else? We have a new story quest.
一版本中
，from him, of course. Yes, baby.
好友之章，了解更多关于他的故事。
That's awesome, dude.
纳维莱特亲自出马，那这群犯罪分子可以有苦头吃。
明智的选择。
Okay, what is gameplay?
是围绕重击展开的。在一段时间的蓄力后，纳维莱特
的重击 wait, what's this?
将持续消耗生命值。
Wait. That's his normal attack skill. Hang on.
纳维莱特。
Oh, you.What the fuck? Wait, you... Okay, so hang on, let me get this straight. You actually hold as a charge attack, and you are charging, and as soon as it takes off, he continually see... He does lose HP then. So that means that he needs 4-piece Marie Chaussee. Okay, now I got it. God damn!
在一段时间的蓄力后，拉维莱特的重击将持续消耗生命值，并释放汹涌的洪流。持续对
Oh, that's so good. Oh my god, that's so good.
纳维莱特当前的生命值越高，重击造成的伤害也就越高，而他的元素战技元素爆发则可以生成一种叫做远水之滴的球。
Dude, that's just dope. That is dope.
吸收前方区域内的远水之滴，恢复他的生命值，并缩短蓄力所需的时间。此外，当纳维莱特处于队伍中时，队伍中自己的角色进行水下弹射的移动速度。
the sprint speed。
纳瓦雷特攻击方式啊
，good，
直观、凌厉，但又不失优雅。那么两位新角色的情
况 ，OK， I need to know the banners, please。
了解了，我们接下来再为大家介绍一下新版本的活动起源安排。
OK， Who is first？
很多旅行者已经等候多时了。
好呀，在 4.1 版本中，纳瓦雷特与
那边的 OK， Who Tao as well？ Oh my God。
在第二期活动起源中， okay. 除了新朋友莱欧斯利外，我们的老朋友温
蒂，温蒂 ，OK，OK，interesting，
并获得概率 up。值得一提的是
，Okay, so hang on, so I'm currently on pity right now. So thank God I was assuming that this dude usually would come first on the even which because they showed him first then the billet, but.Oh my god, dude, it's actually pretty good. So it's good that Hu Tao and Venti are coming back because they are worth it if you guys don't have them. Hu Tao is good, as well as her weapon. But if you have free to play, don't get the weapon. There's no need. But right now, so I have Hu Tao and Venti already, so there's no need. And I need C1 Hu Tao, but at this moment, I don't need it. She's doing fine without C1.I am in need of both characters, Neuvillette and Bruce Lee. So I'm currently on the 50... At 50 pity, at 50-50. I have... I'm about to hit 40 wishes, hopefully before 4.1 drops. I can't wait! It's gonna be so good! So I just want those two, actually. I'm hoping not to lose my 50-50 because it would be a pain in my ass if I do. I'm gonna start to pre-farm those characters. I have the mats already.But they require now new boss drops as well.
胡桃和温迪
，But dude，
在这个版本的活动中与大家见面了。更多信息也会由我的同事稍后为大家。
Okay, so what are those web? Wow, okay, that's a dude. It looks like the one from the crafting table. Tome of the Ephemeral Flow and Cash for Supervision. That looks like a toy.
同时，新版本还会有一些新的武器。加入到武器活动起源中。
Oh, new gacha weapons.
那么在给大家带来新活动的信息之后呢，还请大家休息片刻， 看一下第一则兑换码，之后啊，我们还会给大家带来新版本的场景情报，精彩继续哦。
That's actually pretty good. Jesus Christ. Here's the code. By the way, I'm gonna put it in the pinned comment and the description as well. If you guys haven't redeemed it, it will expire. At 9 p.m. Pacific time. So you guys have I don't know how long it's gonna take from this video coming out. So you have until tonight if you live in the Pacific time. Otherwise, up to you. But we have 10 hours left. But yeah, wow. So I'm on a 50-50 pity. And again, just in case as a reminder, if you guys don't know, I am only a Battle Pass player. So I have stopped spending money on Genesis Crystals because that was only when I was desperate on getting characters. But now that I am up to date, I'm only missing on Kirara. So I really hope that, speaking of Kirara, I hope that she is coming on either Nervalet or Viruzly. Or actually on either one or both of them. Because she's the only one missing so far. I need her. So yeah. God damn, dude. Okay, skipping. Let's go over here. Anniversary. Okay.
Happy anniversary, Genshin Impact. Erica Hoger, voice of Venti here, wishing you a happy anniversary. Me and a few of my fellow voice actors have decided to celebrate by sharing some Genshin-inspired treats. I'll be making a Mondstadt-inspired twist on an autumn classic.
Oh, wow.
An apple cider float. The best part about this recipe is that it doesn't have any fancy kitchen gadgets. Did they update their shibi? Now it's moving. So just get rid of those. All you need is a good saucepan and the ingredients listed here. If you're a younger traveler, make sure there's an adult around to help you with this, okay? First, let's prepare our spices. Start by zesting your orange. Next, pour your favorite non-alcoholic apple cider into a medium saucepan. If you don't have cider, unsweetened apple juice works just as well.
Okay, just recipes. I can watch it later, I guess. So happy anniversary to Genshin Impact. I can't even believe it's been that's the third year anniversary. Holy shit. Okay, so now we're going over here. Jesus Christ. Sorry for skipping, by the way, but I'm getting to the point.
在4.1版本啊，除了丰富的剧情和角色，还有许多全新的场景区域等待着我们的探索。那么今天啊，我也有幸再次邀请到我们的场景美术同学阿汤哥来为我们介绍相应的内容。
旅行者们好，很高兴能够再次来到今天的节目现场，我是原神场景美术阿汤哥，今天也会为大家着重介绍一下 4.1 地区的新场景。
欢迎阿汤哥。上个版本啊，我们已经来到了枫丹，见识到了不同的风土人情，尤其是水下世界的风景啊，给我们带来全新的体验。对于新版本的场景啊，我可是十分期待。那么不妨就从我们身后的
这个开始吧。So yeah, we've seen those on the current version. We couldn't get there.
这个飘浮在空中的水体啊，就让我一直十分好奇啊。阿汤哥，来给我们介绍一下。
没问题。我们身后的这片区域就是旧枫丹科学院的。
Central Laboratory.
在自然。
What the fuck?
依旧延续了枫丹。
Dude, it looks like a roller coaster that has been destroyed.
科学院的某些科技与狠活，
使得整个区域发生了巨
大的爆炸事故。所以上空有着让人惊奇的异重力引擎。
Oh my god！
失重漂浮在海岸上空几百米，十分壮观。也因为这里曾发生的爆炸事故，场景设计上也是会更加的残破与凄凉。
Okay.
优雅精致，这里更带着一丝淡淡的忧伤。
Dude, it looks sick！
一眼望去啊，都是残破的这个遗迹啊。可以想象当初的这个爆炸事故啊，是有多么惨烈。
How do they do those things in real life？
这个场景展现
，Oh my goodness，
稳定性是一大难题。我们利用了水道这个不稳定要素去呼应水体，既满足了概念设定，也为玩家创造了进入异重力凝水体的路线。
这个异重力凝水体，
we can enter from the side in the water。
在这里版本的前瞻节目中有提到，
right.
好像是可以进去的，对吧？
没错。旅行者们是可以设法进入其中的。
That's sick. More to explore. Okay.
秘密就等待大家前去探索了。
话说啊，前面你提到这个叫枫丹科学院的机构啊，听上去太疯狂了吧？居然把这么大片区域都给炸掉了。
是的。
Yeah, of course.
这些其实都源自于枫丹科学院某一次失控的实验。在长久的历史中，枫丹动能工程科学研究院一直在以曾经失去数千命。又总有一天会再度
洪水为敌，
寻找着生存的途径，而蕴含着庞大能量能够粉碎大地桎梏的史基矿则一度被认为是开启救赎大门的钥匙。据此，艾德温·伊斯丁豪斯抵消重力效果。
Yes baby, I can't wait.
但
I am about to farm those boss drops as much as I can. They need 46.
这台实验性成立发生装置也因此失控，停住在科学院的旧址某处。在旅行者们与他遭遇并陷入苦战时，记得利用他提供的失重效果进行跳跃，从而规避他的招式。
哎，他的攻击方式啊，确实跟前遇到的敌人不太一样，感觉很有意思。
Okay.
看来我们的战斗中啊，要多利用他的机制了。
没错，这部为了搜索关于枫丹科学院爆炸的各种情报，愚人众也来到了这一带。
Obviously，
在这里将会遇到新的敌人。愚人众双翼人和愚人众风翼人
Those are new. Oh my god, Frost and Wind. Are you shitting me? I hate those.
可能会给旅行者们带来不小的麻烦。
看来这片新区域啊。
Wait. Sorry, I was talking. What's this red thing above us?
愚人众双翼人和愚人众风翼人，他们来自隶属于仆人的精锐特务组织，拥有不俗的实力。可能会给旅行者们带来不小的麻烦。
What's the red thing?
危险与机遇并存，旅行者们可要小心了哦。那么介绍完地上的区域，这次阿汤哥又给我们带来一些关于水下的情报呢？
自然是有的。接下来我来再着重讲一下梅洛彼得堡，它与 4.1 的主线剧情十分密切。在枫丹惩治犯人的方法。就是将其流放。
Oh my God, that's where we're gonna see the criminals.
看似监狱，本质上却被认定为流放者的聚集地，在这可以参加劳作、生活的。
Wait, they have food there too.
建设在水下，其隐。
Oh my God, that looks good.
和齿轮为主，本身略带精致的工业风也衬托着这里是个威严的地方。我们利用多种竖管道结构，并且尝试了多种排列组合。参考了一些常见的蒸汽朋克元素，提炼出属于枫丹水下监狱的艺术特性，想给初次到达这里的旅行者们留下深刻的印象。
的确如你所说，
That was
给我留下了深刻的印象。
Wow, I can't wait.
不过作为全枫丹罪人的流放场所，它内部的设施数量想必不止如此吧。
在
梅洛彼得堡下方，
还有一处制造着各种机关的
In the factory,
那里就是流放者们平时劳作的地方了。在继承上方区域的蒸汽管道。
Is it about the
绕着重复劳作和流水线的设计语言，借鉴了多种装置意识运用的表达形式，在设计中用重复的环形轨道强调着流水线式的重复感。我们将一部分环形轨道放置于
厂房的底部。What a good facility！
矩阵环形结构也能够给人更强的压迫感。如何让这些精密的齿轮繁而不乱，我们团队也费了不少心思。
能看得出来，虽然是枫丹关押犯人的场所，但我已经等不及去里面探索一番了。
在梅洛彼得堡附近也有不少可以自由探索的区域，这里我向旅行者们介绍一处很隐蔽的水下洞穴，此处被史基矿所影响，产生了奇异的生态景象。旅行者在缠藤中穿梭时会遇到不小的挑战哦。
哎，这非常符合我对水下世界的幻想，各种神秘的区域和
奇
怪的东西总能激发我的探索欲望。
What a mystery! I can't wait.
在这片新的探索区域，想必我们也会遇到一些新的敌人吧？
大伟哥猜的没错，矗立在远海一种
啊 ，new boss，
另一位霸主自泡泡海马寻找而来的
顶尖
掠食者，
electro licorne，
就潜藏在这片区域的某个岩窟之中。它进化出了幻兽的形
态。It really does look like a licorne.
的异海珍珠更是浓缩了雷元素的结晶，让它能够
使用更加猛烈的
元素攻击，也拥有更强的防御能力。此外，在探索水下区域时，我们还会遇到执行警戒、巡弋任务的新型发条机关，旅行者们也要小心哦。
感谢阿汤哥啊！听完你的讲解啊，让我对新版本更加期待了。
Christ, so、
一下子看了那么多内容啊，想必大家也有些累了，不如让我们稍作休息。
Yeah, take a little break, guys.
同学为我们带来更多的内容分享。
You guys are working too hard.
不要走开哦。
Okay, so again, oh okay, so that's for decoration. So I'm gonna take a look again later on, but I want to focus on the main part. Sorry again for skipping. I just want to get into this. By the way, another redemption code. I'm gonna put in the description again. There you go. And Sino is in there. Sino's in there. You can't see. Oh, that's for the tournament.
欢迎大家回到原神四点一百本的前瞻特别节目。
Please tell me you expanding leeway. Hang on.
迎来一场盛大的活动，而我们研发团队中的系统设计师也应邀来到。
Shut up, Target.
给我们介绍新版本丰富多彩的活动内容，来和大家打个招呼吧。大伟哥和屏幕前的旅行者们，大家晚上好，我是系统设计师 Helen， 很高兴又和大家见面了，很荣幸为大家介绍新版本的活动。
Helen， 听说这次在璃月举办的活动和往年不太一样啊。
Come on, can you tell us about the tea place？
确实有些与众不同，不知道大伟哥还记不记得今年海灯节的那场饭局？当然记得，就是那场胡桃做东，温迪和钟离均有出席啊，甚至连降魔大神萧都在场的饭局吧？哦，3.4。没错，这个饭局的许多细节都让人会心一笑。
也让温迪和璃月的众人相识，胡桃和温迪还做下了承诺，将来有空一起写诗。这不，正巧让他们逮到一个机会，由胡桃与温迪牵头，在石门附近举行了两国合办的诗歌大会，交流诗歌的同时，促进两国关系和谐友善发展。希望在诗歌中让大家感受节日的氛围。
Does that mean we're gonna
没想到他们来真的，不过温迪作为吟游诗人，他的创作水平应该相当高啊，而胡桃的打油诗也独具一格嘛。不仅仅是他们，还有来自璃月和蒙德的其他伙伴也一起参加了大会，十分热闹。不过在活动期间发生了一件奇异的事，身为参赛者的重云提出，自己之前见到了一个类似妖邪的东西，于是。 众人在参加大会的同时，也开始探寻起了事件的真相。诗歌大会举办的那么隆重，想必与之相关的活动也很丰富吧。这次我们为旅行者们准备了三个特色活动玩法。Oh,
event！
就是百步理智、灵感喷击和寻景密画。在百步理智玩法中，旅行者可以投出掷箭。
I'm curious about this weapon. What is this？
用掷箭尽可能多的命中龙壶。 从而获得更高的积分。在挑战的过程中，会出现礼环和妙壶。如果投掷的掷箭穿过礼环击中龙壶，即可获得双倍积分。Oh
my god! It was like a thing you go when there's like a festival.
帮助旅行者更高效地完成挑战。I
think.
第二个活动是挑战。
I played too many games outside.
在挑战开始后，旅行者打倒敌人可以获得灵感结晶。 挑战中有时会出现携带迷思元结的敌人，极为坚韧，难以击倒。Can
you use your sword, please?
一段时间会在角色身边引发一定范围的冲击波，造成巨量伤害。如果能灵活运用灵感结晶的冲击波，或许能轻松打倒这类敌人。
Oh wow! So he's only releasing shockwaves on it.
是一个通过拍照来寻找缺失景物的玩法。根据提示。 旅行者需要帮助画作修复师，通过拍照修复画作。在拍照时，将画片
Oh wow!
寻找画片上缺失的景物。Oh
wait, that reminds me of the event we did that already, I think.
记录下来并获得奖励。Oh
shit!
在本次游水运诗集活动中，旅行者们可以参与三个活动挑战，提升诗歌绘画。
Then the lion bookmark. I'm curious about what this does. Is that like the
及其专属精炼道具等丰富奖励。这次的活动还尤其是百步理智活动啊，让我想起了小时候经常玩的这个投壶游戏。这次啊，我也可以在游戏中再体验一把了。是啊，希望这次的活动能让旅行者们感受到诗歌大会欢快的氛围，与蒙德和璃月的大家一起度过令人难忘的时光。说到蒙德，可莉又活跃了起来呢。怎么？
难道可莉又因为炸鱼被秦团长抓了吗？
喂，What did Kelly do？
这次可不是闯祸，反而立功了。他在游玩的过程中 偶然发现国舅湖里突然出现了从须弥来的入侵鱼类。为了维持生态平衡，骑士团需要处理这些入侵物种。在此期间，可莉为了不添乱，只能待在蒙德城里。为了不让可莉无聊，丽莎发明了一个有趣的小游戏。在活动《嘟嘟可轰轰奇遇记》中
，Oh my God, another key event related.
一起玩蹦蹦炸弹，通过操作嘟嘟可投出不同类型的蹦蹦炸弹，击败角角鱼大军，书写嘟嘟可打败鱼鱼入侵者的大冒险。
火花骑士就像火热的小太阳一样，每次都能给我们带来惊喜呀！这次竟然还发现了入侵物种。
其实有类似困扰的不只是蒙德。在枫丹也有一些本应只存在于实验室内的奇妙生物，突然出现在枫丹的各个水域中。
That's
weird. 旅行者可以通过
荧
光携带活动，帮助为此事忙得焦头烂额的商人姬肖恩，通过回收枫丹水下各处的荧光紫水母，消除生态隐患。
Okay, another that's what I like to do.
保护生态
，swimming events,
还能欣赏枫丹水下风光。
I love them.
真是一举两得呀。
是的。在枫丹苍鲸区东南侧的水岸处，我们还可以体验到挑战活动“人生的波峰与波谷”。在这个挑战活动中，旅行者可以帮助枫丹研究员测试超高压冲击器，通过合理把握停止增压的时机，提高超高压冲击器释放的超高压冲击波的伤害，来击败敌人。
Oh shit！
同时，旅行者可以根据出战队伍的角色数量和等级。获取载荷，用来装配更高等级的增益模组，挑战更高难度的敌人。在
you can do the buffs and okay, depending on the teams you take.
牺牲召唤的铸镜演练也将再次。
Oh, of course, okay, yeah, it's kind of coming every single patch now.
获取积分来领取奖励。
What the excuse me? What? Oh my, I'm so sorry. I paused it brutally. Dia, Wander, and Yao Yao. Wander though. Oh shit. What? Wander?
最后，在 4.1 版本，我们还会开启精通乙勇。
Oh my god.
需要培养角色的旅行者。
I'm going back to TCG again, dude. God damn it, dude.
辛苦研发组的同学，
对啊 ，four events，
那么多有趣的活动
gems,、okay.
看得我都眼花缭乱了，已经迫不及待想去试玩一番了。
另一方面，我们也一直在关注旅行者们的日常游玩状况。随着游戏运营年份增长，一些原本看起来合理的前期和常规设计，如今却成为了旅行者们体验中的痛点。因此，我们在 4.1 版本对前期的内容设计做了部分调整。
What did you guys do?
我们加强了冒险等阶突破任务的提示，在旅行者们的派蒙界面。
Okay, good. Thank God. Okay.
都增加了相应的引导。
You should have done this before. It's kind of complicated to see where was the ascension quest with all of those stuff we had before.
来帮助新手。
Okay.
更好的完成突破任务。
They reduce the difficulty of passing through those domains. That is actually good. Perfect.Finally, a friend who plays in Europe wanted to play in NA as well, but she keeps telling me that she can't go through them because the enemies were very strong enough. Also, I do kind of blame my phone for interrupting what I was saying, but it's also because of them. They didn't build enough characters. So yeah, but just in case, that's good for newcomers. That is good.
这个好。其实啊，当初我第一次做突破任务时啊，确实用了挺长的时间啊。这次的调整啊，应该能帮助到不少的人。
That is awesome.
不仅如此，我们还对每日委托做了一次重大调整。随着游戏内容逐渐丰富，在每日委托之外，游戏内还有大量玩法等着旅行者体验。因此，我们在 4.1 版本推出了冒险历练系统。
Adventure Encounters.
在这个系统中，旅行者。
Wait a minute.
可以通过完成任务、开启宝箱、获取收集物、参与活动的方式来获取历练点。
Encounter points. Wait. That's part of the dailies? Are you kidding me? Oh wow!
除了原本的， 通过完
成 more primogems, that is interesting.
旅行者也可以通过累积历练点来换取委托奖励，每天通过两种方式累计最多领取。
哦，哇哦！
每日委托奖励被领取。
Oh wait, it does count towards it though. Hang on.
累计最多领取。
Oh, okay, so I've encountered point stage. Oh, it gives you the same thing. Ah, dude, I thought it was more. Okay, no, it would have been too much otherwise. I've thought too much.
被领取后仍可进行任务。想要体验任务或者完成成就的旅行
者。That is pretty good.
继续去完成这些委托。历练点将在服务器时间每天的凌晨四点清零。
太棒了，我很早就喜欢有类似的系统。
Now ladies can be more exciting. That's perfect.
总感觉要做的事情太多。
Awesome. I'm very excited now.
现在有了这个功能啊，我在体验其他内容的同时啊，还能够获得委托奖励，真可谓是一举两得啊。
没错，我们也希望旅行者们可以更多的享
受。That's all we got right now for the optimization.
得到多元化的体验。
除了版本活动与系统优化。在公测三周年之际啊，我们依旧为旅行者们准备了一些神秘的奖励来庆祝这个特殊的日子。 Helen， 你来为大家分享一下情报吧。
What do you guys have？
为了感谢旅行者们一直以来的支持与热爱，在 4.1 版本期间，签到活动观赏流华将会开启。旅行者们可以通过签到获得最多10枚纠缠之源以及其他道具奖励。
What？
不容错过。同时我们还会通过邮寄
Initial bonus reset top up，
额外奉上总共1600原石和四个脆弱树枝，以及两个特殊纪念小道具。
Wait, this is what we're getting? Oh my god! Okay, hang on. Wait. So we're gonna have the daily check-in event in the game. A total of 10 into one phase. So we get like 10 wishes in total, plus this 20 wishes. 4 fragile resin and 2 gadgets. And also the top ups bonus reset will also be reset after 4.1 update. Oh my god, that is good.
便携式空气动力胶质炮生发器和柔柔小章。
Oh my god, that's actually big.
此外，在 4.1 版本更新后，游戏内商城的首充双倍状态也将会展示。
Okay, now people can be like, did you spend money on content yet? I won't now. I'm not.
相信大家已经和我一样十分期待 4.1 版本的到来了。
I think there's like no need to spend anymore. I'm gonna get curious.
大家不妨稍作休息。接下来啊，还有更多有趣的内容，后面的节目更加精彩。
Oh my goodness. Okay. What's this?Oh, it's non-profit in Mexico. Oh my god, that's so cute. Oh, handsome. The music, it's so good. I think it's, wow, I want those t-shirts. I think that's the first Windbloom, event patch.I love this event, it gives me goosebumps. Wow, they did good. I'm very glad they did this. I like dogs, so they deserve the best. I'm gonna skip this again. Sorry again, but if you guys have watched it, that's fine, because I don't want to watch it now. I'm probably watching it on my own time, because it's gonna be available whenever they can. So yeah.
在今天这个特殊的日子，能够和屏幕前的旅行者们共同庆祝此刻。
Head of marketing，
值得高兴的是，从2020年公测至今啊，相信大家在提瓦特大陆上也留下了属于自己的独特回忆啊。这三年以来啊，不只是各位旅行者，我们研发团队的同学也同样经历了一段宝贵的时光，想要和大家分享。坐在我身边的呢，是大家老朋友 Michael。Michael， 趁着今天这个机会，不妨为我们讲讲项目组内部的故事吧。
感谢大伟哥的邀请，旅行者们好，很高兴又与大家见面了。
这今
天我也很荣幸能代表项目组的同学为大家分享内部的故事，不过由于时间有限，因此我们简单做了整理，统计了一些有趣的数据给大家带来分享。
哦，这和我之前所想的内容还不太一样，那这些数据背后是不是有什么故事啊？
大伟哥猜对了，每个数字背后啊，都有着原神研发团队持续的付出和深厚的感情。接下来就让我们看看第一组数据吧。
What the fuck？
1000多万啊，这可是个大数字啊 ！Michael， 这个数字是什么意思啊？
这个数字其实是原神研发以来，我们的 IP 团队在游戏内外创作的叙事文本总字数。
What the hell？
我们游戏中的提瓦特大陆是一个架空世界。
That much？
这里汇聚了各种文化、创意、艺术。从零开始构建它的世界观并不容易。原神 IP 创作团队的同学以制作
Yeah, no kidding. Jesus Christ, the map is getting bigger and bigger as the time goes on.
编织了一个个扣人心弦的故事，构建了一个宏大精美的世界。细心的旅行者可能会发现，在游戏中处处充满着细节。随意拾取的一本书籍，不经意间获取的武器，副本中掉落的圣遗物，他们的背后甚至也有属于自己的
故事。Oh yeah, the artifact drops and the story behind them.
其实，为了把一个架空世界填满的足够有真实感，光靠游戏内的文本是不够的。在许多内容呈现给旅行者之前 ，IP 团队就要先行构思几个版本。甚至几年后的概念设定，对于一些要向美术策划海外本地化团队表达的设定，也需要撰写足够细腻详尽的文档
提供
参考。因此在游戏内所呈现的内容大概也只是浮在创作海洋的一角冰山。
确实啊，这个数字不仅是代表一场游戏的这个制作，更是一次文化的积淀，一次创意的盛宴。
当然海量的文本创作也只是原神内容的其中一个侧写，下面这个数字看起来可小多了，但它也是我们和旅行者一路走来的证明之一呢。
74，
比起第一个数字啊，这个数字是有点小了。
Yeah, little.
Michael， 你说这是我们跟旅行者一路走来的见证，那它一定是一个随着版本累积下来的数字，对不对？
大伟哥已经快要猜到了。其实啊，这是直到 4.1 版本为止，包括刚才我的同事介绍的。
Oh right, God damn it! I was gonna say the total characters that we got so far.
纳维莱特和莱
欧。Wow.
原神已经向旅行者推出的角色数量。
没想到啊，在不知不觉间啊。
This is pretty good. Wow, 74 characters in total has been released. But what? Okay.I'm still missing Kiara. I wonder if Kiara will come now on those banners. So yeah, I'm not gonna watch the whole this entire sequence. So it's just for the birthday. I'm glad that they have worked together, throughout the years. I love Genshin Impact. It's actually good. Oh wait, what is this? I want to see it. Oh my god! Wait, let me hide my webcam. Which was my webcam? No, not that one. That one.That's a sick wallpaper. That's for the 3rd anniversary. And now Fukuro is here. Oh my god. Dude, happy anniversary to Genshin Impact. 3 years already. I can't believe this shit. It's been 3 years. I'm just... I don't know what to say, dude. That's for the anniversary. Okay.So that's how we got then, right? Jesus Christ. Just to be honest, I am so happy about this. I am very happy. Wait, where's my... Oh, okay. My stream deck is not working. Good. I'm so happy that we have... That I started Genshin Impact again.As a reminder, I started a year after the game was out. So when Inazuma was out, I was playing on the 2.1 second half. When Kokomi was out, I had no idea about how everything worked out from here. But now I do, because I played the game. So It's unbelievable. It has been 3 years already. Man. So I'm looking forward for the new region of Fontaine. When I saw the Liyue sequence here, I was expecting to be like a map expansion on the tea house. But it doesn't look like it is actually. So I really wonder if it is like just a sign for the next patch of 4.2. But I can't wait. So thank you again for watching. Sorry again if I didn't stream. I was very tired. I didn't have enough stamina to stay in the middle of the night to watch the live stream. So I wanted to hope to watch it on myself on sequences I wanted to know. But again, you can watch it on your own. It's available on the YouTube channel. And I'm looking forward for both Neuvillette and VOZ. I'm going to be summoning for both of them. Hopefully, I'm getting the 50-50 win. So yeah, thank you again so much, guys, for your support again. We just reached 1,700 subscribers on YouTube. It's unbelievable. I can't even believe it. I did like 40 runs without counting one VOD and my reaction to the thing, to the 4.0 program. It's unbelievable. My videos have been taking off ever since I was doing the Spiral Abyss. I wanted to do those for a long time, but I suck at name calling teams and renaming teams, so that's why I'm like looking up on internet and see what I would call this team with those characters specifically. So that's why I do this. So yeah. Thank you again. We are slowly approaching to 2k subs. So please, if you haven't done that, don't forget to do that. Appreciate it. With that said, I'm looking forward. So September 26th should be the day of 4.0. Let me look at it again. September 26th. Okay. September 26th at 3 p.m. Pacific time will be the maintenance that drops. I am so excited because I want Neuvillette and Vriosly. Both of them. I can't wait. So let's do this. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to cut the stream now. The recording. Thank you. Bye, everyone. Happy anniversary again. Genshin Impact. So nuts.